Thank you. Good afternoon. This is Sethuraman Panchanathan, Director of the National Science Foundation. This is an open meeting and is being live streamed on YouTube for members of the public who have an interest in listening in on the discussion. The committee's executive secretary is Dr. Nirmala Kannankutty, who is going to make an opening statement and conduct the roll call. Nimi?
Thank you, Dr. Panchanathan. My name is Nimi Kannankutty. Executive committee is beginning an open meeting on July 11th, 2022 at 12:30 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time via Zoom teleconference. Executive committee members, please indicate present as I read your name. Sethuraman Panchanathan.
Here.
Dan Reed.
Here.
Victor McCrary.
Present.
Julia Phillips.
Present.
Dario Gill.
Here.
Thank you. I will now conduct a roll call of the other members of the board. Please indicate present as I read your name. Suresh Babu. Roger Beachy. Maureen Condich.
Here.
Aaron Dominguez. Suresh Garamella.
Yeah, here.
Melvin Huff. Stephen Lee.
Present.
Matthew Malkin.
Present.
Scott Stanley.
Here.
Ellen Stern. Stephen Willard.
Here.
And Heather Wilson.
Here.
Staff of the National Science Board office are also on the call, including John Basie, Andrea Rambo, Anne Bushmiller, and liaisons of the board committees. NSF staff who serve as executive secretaries to the board committees are also present. Karen Maringel, the agency's chief operating officer, Brian Stone, the chief of staff, as well as several assistant directors and office heads are also on the call should we need their expertise. Thank you all. During the meeting, please identify yourself before speaking. Dr. Panchanathan, you may proceed with today's teleconference.
Thank you, Nimi. The first agenda item is the approval of the minutes of the prior executive committee meetings. Last week, the executive committee members received electronic copies of the minutes of the committee meeting of April 5th, 2022. Does any EC member have corrections for these minutes? If not, we will consider them approved as presented. Hearing none, we will assume that it is now approved as presented. The next agenda item is basically to discuss the NSB meeting scheduled for the agenda for the NSB meeting scheduled for August 3rd, 4th of 2022. So we'll now, that's basically the main portion of the meeting to review the preliminary agenda for the meeting, which was sent out to all the National Science Board members during the past few days. So Dan, over to you, sir.
Thanks, Panch, and I hope all of the committee chairs will chime in at the appropriate time. So we've been working with the board office and with NSF to craft agenda items. One of the things on the agenda that's pending our notification is whether we will have new members in time for the board. We're all hoping we will. If so, we will introduce those and swear them in at the beginning of the meeting. Punch will offer his usual comments. Punch, maybe I'll throw the floor back to you to see if there are any items you wish to share as a prelude, and then we'll sort of plunge into some of the committee issues.
Thank you, Dan. I mean, as always, you know, we give an overview of all the things that's happening at NSF, and it also gives them, more importantly, a chance for us to share the cool science projects that we want to profile with you all. So we are already making plans for that, and I think it'll come together nicely. So look forward to that.
Thanks, Punch. And I will offer a summary of the visits that Vic and I had on the Hill over the summer, talking to authorization and appropriation committee staffers, as well as a meeting at OSTP and the American Chemical Society. We'll talk about some of the political developments over the summer in both the opening and closing remarks. There's scheduled to be an update on research security You may remember as well that there's a National Academy study that's been launched to look at these issues also. In addition, we'll get an update from the foundation in terms of activities there. We do need to finalize meeting dates for the coming year, and that will be an item. And then, as always, the big discussion items will be about the open and closed committee reports. And so I will simply go across the committees and ask each of the new committee chairs if they have any thoughts they want to offer about priority items, recognizing that this is an open meeting. So, Steve Leith, are you you sitting in for? Well, let's do it.
I was just being curious. Steve Willard's on the call, and he's the chair.
Yeah.
On this place,
yeah. All right. Well, let's start with that. So, Steve, you thoughts on oversight?
Sure. Basically, there are seven fundamental items. We have a lot of work with meeting with NSF staff. That includes the CFO and the general the inspector general. But there are many other meetings that NIMI and the staff have thoughtfully put together for support of our oversight function. A second issue is data collection. We want to be more robust in how we collect data throughout our process. The Merit Review Digest of 2021, our continuing work on broader impacts, enterprise risk management and TIP, and what we may want to do differently to reflect the differences of TIP, the EPSCoR, and a larger effort to re-examine the merit review process.
All right. Thanks, Steve. Let's see. Suresh, thoughts on the Committee on Strategy, knowing that you're having a retreat on Friday?
Yeah, thank you. We'll be having a closed meeting this Friday to look at NSF's plans and in response to some of the priorities that I think the committee has identified. And not surprisingly, we are focused on sort of strengthening core NSF, as established NSF, I think we're calling it. You know, what our actions will be around the missing millions and certainly the TIP effort. So those will be three major themes we will look to NSF to sort of work with us on, you know, longer term strategy on these things, besides the usual budget issues. So I think I'll leave it at that.
All right, thanks, Suresh. Dario, external engagement.
Yeah, so we plan to have a 1-hour retreat on August 3rd. And you know, we're going to be laying out discussing some of the plans for the year, and particularly what kind of, you know, different communities that we want to activate in support of the priorities of the board. And you know, so we're just getting geared up for the next 2 years, and we're looking forward to that meeting.
All right, Julia, there's a hefty agenda for the August meeting around ANF issues, MagLab, NORLAB, the regional research vessels, the SAGE gauge, and the large scale computing facility. Thoughts about ANF?
Well, I think, you know, as this notional agenda indicates, most of that is going to be in the closed session. And yeah, it's a really heavy lift. Some of the issues, you know, and then there are other things around facilities where things have not necessarily gone according to plan, the fire on Kitt Peak and of course, Arecibo, so forth. I don't think we're going to have, and then there's new legislation in Hawaii that may affect the telescopes in the long term. None of that, I believe, is going to come up in this particular meeting. However, we will at least want to mention those. And anyway, it's going to be a very tight agenda. Another thing that I'm very sorry. I'll be back in a minute after this finishes. Okay, I think it's finished. Anyway, The big issue, I think, is going to be around risk and thinking about the risk associated with all facilities. So, you know, the idea being no more surprises or at least fewer surprises. And the ANF Antarctic Strategy Update is also something we're expecting in the closed session. So this is going to be a really heavy meeting. There are lots of ANF meetings between now and when the meeting, the actual board meeting occurs. And so how all of that shapes up is still a bit in limbo.
All right, thanks, Julia. And Maureen, thoughts on SCP?
Well, we are of course gearing up for indicators 2024 already, and continuing the process initiated under Julia's directorship of streamlining the thematic reports and trying to think of ways that we can improve communication to get sort of optimal input from board members at the time when that input would have the greatest impact on the content and organization of the reports. We're also exploring ways to think more broadly about collaborating with other committees as part of establishing priorities for policy pieces moving forward. So we have a lot of committees that are interested in our interface with the public, and we would like to be able to talk more efficiently with them to help identify high priority areas for policy pieces. So that's where we are.
All right, thanks. Matt, since you're here, I'll ask if you have anything you want to share about OSCE discussions as part of the sort of broader inclusion agenda that we're all pursuing.
So you're referring to OSCE?
Yes.
Well, right now, we've got a draft of a one-pager because we want to present to the board just to basically continue the discussions with the board. And I think that the main target for this, since you've got such a full meeting in August, is going to be at the September retreat. So we have a lot of ideas to discuss, and we definitely need more board inputs. But I don't think that we have to spend too much of the August meeting on it, if that's what you're... We could have a really short update there if there was time for it.
All right, thanks, Matt. That's the highlight of the broad topics. I'll ask if anyone from the board office or NSF has other things they want to share. Julia.
Thank you. I noticed there's an SES bullet there under SCP, and that group is meeting on Friday. And so I anticipate we would have at least, you know, sort of 5 minutes of report there.
Okay. Any other discussion items? Panch, any closing thoughts?
I think Suresh alluded to this. Depending on the outcome of the retreat that happens, the meeting that happens on the 15th, and then subsequent information being provided, sort of the authorization to transmit might be something that we can bring up in this meeting potentially. And so that way, you know, we don't have to worry about the board members being disturbed later on. So we can work through that depending on how things evolve.
All right, anything else? Otherwise, this will be a brief meeting.
Being well, Dan, keep it up.
All right, Nimi, I'll hand the floor back to you if you want to sing us out here.
No, basically, that's exactly it. I mean, Nimi will now announce the adjournment with her usual, the final words that she has to share.
Julia, did you have something else you wanted to say? Your hand was still up. No, okay.
No, sorry.
Well, thank you, everybody. And thank you for a very efficient meeting. This meeting is officially adjourned at 12:46 p.m. Thank you very much.
Thank you all. Great seeing all of you.
Good seeing you.
Happy summer.
Look forward to seeing you all soon. Thank you.
Yeah, likewise.
Ditto. Take care, everybody.
Take care. Bye.